It's Investigator Greg Edwards phone call with Jamey Bearden. Today's date, September 9th, 2014, time 1:52 p.m.
Jamey?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry about that. I just had to get up and shut my door. I don't like everybody listening to me talk.
No, it's fine. I understand. Sorry to just get back with you. Friday, I didn't get your message till late after school, and then yesterday I had a migraine, so I wasn't going to call you on migraine medication.
Oh, no. I understand completely. Usually when you have a migraine, you don't feel like talking to anybody anyway. I've experienced those myself. I think I've only had about three in my life, but you never forget them.
No, I know. They're bad. But, anyways, I had received your message about the political rally at Burt's farm.
Mm-hmm.
And Clint had said that he had spoken with the sheriff's department, so I was just going to...
Yeah, that's what I was calling you about. Really, what I'm trying to do is just get everybody's take on what they saw and or what they heard. You know, just what you saw and what you heard, not anything else. And just talk me through what you seen that happen, if you don't mind. And do you know what I'm referring to?
I know what you're referring to.
Okay.
As far as what happened. We were all, before the speaking began, everyone was in the barn,
mm-hmm.
kind of for a meet and greet,
mm-hmm.
and they, just went over, they were excited, blah, 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 and they'd asked people not, to film anything, and there was actually, I think, one, if not two people that left, guys that were going to just come film,
mm-hmm.
so I know, I'm not trying to sound weird, but I know that was heard. And then during the speaking, I think it was the third speaker, and I'm really sorry, but
okay.
I don't...
No, that's okay.
Let me
interrupt you real quick, Jamey, and I'll let you get back to it. I just want to make sure I get this straight as we go on. You said when everybody was in there, was it... And they had mentioned, not having any cameras there or any video
right.
cameras. Was that something that pretty much everybody heard? I mean, was that well known?
I believe it was because I had a toddler and an 18-month-old with me, and
mm-hmm.
the room was crowded, but they kind of were we're about to go start the speeches, and we asked this, and everyone was quiet and watching, so
and they were
it was heard.
Right.
I mean, I
and they were
wrong.
We asked if no one would videotape this and so forth.
Right. Yeah.
Who was it that said that, if you don't mind me asking?
I believe that was Clint that said that.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it was Clint. I could be
right.
wrong, but
uh-huh.
I think it was Clint or it was the guy in the ball cap, which I don't know which. I don't know if he was with the Republican Party overall or if he was with somebody's particular campaign.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, but it wasn't from one campaign. It was
right.
just we don't want this recorded. The candidates don't have people here to record, so we just, we ask that you don't record anything.
Okay.
Don't quote, that's what I got from it. I'm not saying that's a direct quote, but
right.
the way I understood it. And so then everybody went from the barn to the covered area
mm-hmm.
where they had everything set up. And I sat towards the back because I had the boys with me, and toddlers, if you have kids, kind of...
Right, you kind of go to the back.
They don't, you don't want to interrupt anyone.
Right.
But
no, I understand. It's kind of like church.
Yeah, you don't want to, just really distract from the people who are really there to hear the speeches.
Right.
But I could... I mean, it wasn't full, the crowd. It wasn't filled up by any means. So we were probably maybe a little past halfway back, but it still wasn't far away. But, I think it was about the third speaker.
Were you in the same row as
no,
Nydia Tisdale?
No, I was in... What I was in was the... there were two sides. And
mm-hmm.
she was on the left side, but the front seat of the left side. So she was probably,
right.
between 5 and maybe, 7 or 8 feet from the speakers because there wasn't a podium.
Right.
And I really just remember, as far as her, she stood out because she had this camera and it had a small boom mic on it.
Yeah.
So, and she was kind of leaning with it.
Mm-hmm.
So to me it was, just from the get, I didn't know who she was or what she was doing, but I was kind of like, that's a little intrusive, because I wouldn't want someone having a camera in my face, regardless of if I ask, you know, one of my students or whatever reason it was being recorded. I just thought it was kind of weird, because it was like right in their face,
mm-hmm.
from my perspective. But so I noticed that, like, that was kind of a, no one else was doing it, and, you know, she was right there. But I think it, like I said, I think it was, like, the third candidate that was speaking. It may have been the second. I don't know. But the man in the ball cap went over to her, because he and Clint and Tony, and it seems like there was maybe one other person standing to the side, like, on the left side, if I'm viewing the speeches,
mm-hmm.
like, the left side under the, like, beside the chair line.
Right.
So they were all kind of standing in front of that front row. So they weren't behind the chairs. Like, to me, they were, like, not to me, but from my view, they were in front of them. So you could see them. Like, they were closer to the speakers.
Right.
Or the candidates, I guess I should call them. But anyway, so he kind of walked behind the first row and talk to her. I don't know what he said, because I can't hear from that.
Right, and this is Clint, or the guy in the ball cap?
The guy in the ball cap.
Okay.
And he went and asked her, I mean, I'm assuming, you know, to stop recording. I don't know. And then a few minutes later, like, she didn't. She kind of shooed him away. And a few minutes later, Clint did the same thing. And I don't know what Clint said either, but I do know that he told, I don't know if he wants this or not, but he said that she said, like, you're messing up my recording, go away. But I didn't hear that, because I wasn't that close.
Right.
And then Johnny, like, Clint and Tony went and talked to Johnny and Kathy Burt, because I think they were, I mean, they were, in my opinion, they were probably saying, like, she won't stop recording. I don't really know what they were saying. But they went and talked to him, and then they walked back around, and both went over there. Like, Tony was first, and Clint was behind Tony. And she started, like, throwing her arms up, kind of like a, to me, like a fit, you know, like a toddler fit in a way.
Did she start throwing her arms up before she was touched by anybody?
Yes. No, I this part, like, I know it sounds crazy, I remember this part, because there's been so many bad things on the news.
Okay.
And this is, like, the third time that this lady's been talked to, and she starts throwing her arms up and her elbows back. And then Tony puts his hands on her shoulders, like the sides of her shoulders. And I just hear him say, you know, like, you're going to have to leave. And then she keeps, like, throwing her arms up and, like, trying to hit him.
And she's still not being touched at this time.
No, I'm saying, like, when, like, she was in her arms up first, like, kind of reaching back, like, don't touch me, you know, like, kind of hitting and elbowing.
Okay.
And then, so he's crouched behind her, and she's seated. And then once she does that, I think he's told her, like, you have to, you know, you're going to have to leave. And he grabs her shoulders, like, the sides of her shoulders, the top of her arms.
Right, from behind her, right?
From behind her.
Okay.
And she, I feel like, well, anyways, she keeps hitting and doing all that and screaming, like, what's your name? And Tony just kind of walks her out. But she's, like, pitching this huge fit again. Not again, it's a continuation.
Right.
And just keeps kind of acting a fool, in my opinion. I know that's probably not good terminology, but
no,
she goes from nothing to, like, this over freak out moment. And I really feel like, which I know my opinion doesn't matter, but I feel like she knew she was getting attention,
mm-hmm.
or, like, this is going to be my storyline, and so that's why she freaked out.
Right.
Like, I didn't see any reason for her to have that reaction.
Right.
Because she reacted before he even touched her.
Now, when Clint and Tony went over to Johnny, was Kathy there too? Was she standing with Johnny?
Yeah, they were all seated. They were seated probably, like, maybe, like, five rows in front of me.
Okay, Kathy and Johnny.
Yeah, and I think their daughter was there, too.
Casey?
I'm pretty sure that Casey was seated, and her husband. They were all seated together. And her husband wasn't seated, like, he was standing, like, on that row.
Because mm-hmm.
they may have came in a little bit because they had been working, but they were all, like, right there in the same area.
Okay. And now, when Clint and Tony approached her after, you know, after they talked to Johnny, you said Tony was behind her. Where was Clint exactly?
Clint, okay, so if Tony is directly behind her, Clint is to the left of Tony.
Okay, so it's just standing beside Tony.
Yes.
Okay.
And you can't. I mean, I don't know if y'all can tell her. I saw a piece of that video, and you can't really tell anything because she. I mean, it was a video and the speeches, and then she kind of started shaking the camera and doing all that stuff. But they were both behind her. But I feel like from the position they originally were in, like if I was her, they were standing to my left, but in front of me. Does that make sense? Like within, like to me, within sight. So
right.
I feel like she knew who was coming to talk to her because they all came from that same space.
Mm-hmm.
Because I remember, like, I know it's been 2 weeks, but I remember thinking, like, while it was happening, like, she knows she's getting attention and she's just doing this, like, for attention or whatever. I don't know what reason she was there, but it just seemed to me like it was a little overdone.
Right.
If that makes sense. Like, if someone had spoke to me like that, that wouldn't be my reaction.
Right, I understand. And not to harp on this, and I'm sorry to... I really hate to bother you with this, Jamey. I do.
Well, I'm trying not to be. I know I have a lot of opinions on it. I'm trying to be factual, but it just seemed like it was.
No, that's fine.
It was kind of crazy.
When they initially approached her and she threw her arms up before they touched her, did she continue to kind of throw her arms up and stuff? And
oh yeah, like once she started throwing her arms up, right. Like she stayed doing that.
And then Tony eventually put his hands on her and escorted her out,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, he did. Okay. And he was, you know, I mean, I haven't seen too many situations like that, but as far as that goes, like, if someone had been, like, hitting me in the face and throwing their arms at me, like, I thought he was really calm because I thought that, you know, if somebody was doing that, like, the arms might go behind the back or something else, but he just handled it by putting his arms on her shoulders.
Right. So
you know, to keep them down.
You think she was trying to hit him?
Yeah, I think she was. And then I think she realized later that it was a police officer, and not that you should hit anyone, but
right.
I think she probably had a moment like, oh, I've hit a police officer. And
right. Did you see her hit him or just try to hit him?
No, I felt, I mean, which like I said, I was farther back. I wasn't directly
right.
behind them, but
understand.
I thought she hit him in the face a couple times.
Okay.
Because she went straight back. When she started flailing her arms, I mean, it was straight back.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't like a swat, like, get away from me. Like, she just started throwing her arms back.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't know why else she would do that. Like, I think the intent was there to hit whoever was behind her.
Right.
And when he was pulling her away, like, she was still doing that, and she was kind of kicking her legs. I mean, I don't know, you know, with that part, because there's some posts blocking the view, you know, when they're walking out, but she was still fighting. And Tony, I know he was in the short sleeve knit, but I saw him beforehand. I mean, I know who he is, but you can tell he's a police officer. I mean, he had his weapon, he had the badge on the shirt. I mean, I don't know. I just feel
right.
like, you know, it's a police officer.
He was pretty readily identifiable.
Right. And I feel like he was in her field of vision.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm also trying to say. Like, I feel like all three of those people were, because they were standing to the side, but in the front.
Mm-hmm.
So if I was sitting there, like, I would see them. I wouldn't, you know, they wouldn't, I don't know how you wouldn't know they were there.
Right.
And nobody else, because there was speaking going on, no one else was walking around, so I wouldn't assume that someone that's walking towards me is not the person that's behind me.
Right.
I guess that's a lot of assumption. And then the only other thing that we heard, because she kept, I guess, kind of fighting back or whatever she was doing, probably like 10 minutes later, she started screaming, like, help.
Right. While she was in the barn?
Yes, she's either in the barn or she was, like, on the other side of the barn getting the police car. I don't know what they were doing, but
right. She
started screaming help. And this, I know I'm not trying to be mean, but the crowd kind of laughed because she was hysterical, but not, like, because somebody was hurting her. She was
She was hysterical to the point
where
it was acting and not to where she actually needed
help.
Right.
I don't want to sound like we're cold. You're right. I don't want to sound like we're cold people, but no one, in my opinion, the crowd did not think that she was being harmed in any way. And I don't feel like she was, you know what I mean? Like, she was screaming help, and it was like, seriously, is she still going? I mean, that was, to me, the reaction of the crowd when she was doing that. We're like, oh, she's still here.
Yeah.
you know, because there was kind of like this laugh. But I don't think it was like a mean laugh, like, oh, she's getting hurt or something like that. It mm-hmm. was just kind of like a, wow, she's really still at it.
Right.
Kind of thing. But I didn't go in the barn because I had my kids with me, so I wasn't going to take them in there, even though Clint went in the barn. So I just stayed out. But I do know, like, once Clint and Tony, Clint followed Tony into the barn, and then Johnny and Kathy went into the barn, too. And then I think at some point Casey got up, or Casey and her husband, and okay. went in there as well. But I'm not right. certain on the order of that, or if all four of those people. But I know Johnny and Kathy got up and went in, I guess, to talk to her. I don't know.
Okay. Give me just a second, Jamey. I'm just trying to write this down as we go.
And then I think in the, sorry, I'm trying to remember. No, I think I know. I don't know if it was before Johnny and Kathy went in there or after. I feel like it's after, but Linda Umberger, she's the only one that got up and left, and she got up and left through the barn, so.
Okay, left the property?
Yes.
Okay.
But no one else got up.
No one else got up and left?
No one else got up and left. Okay. She was the only one that
until it was over.
Everyone else sat there and listened to the rest of the speeches, except for Linda. And I just know it because I know Linda, and then she just kind of got up and stormed out, and I was like, okay. But thinking okay. about it.
All right. In just a second, I got a couple more questions for you. I won't take too much of your time, Jamey.
That's fine. I don't have a class right now, so it's okay.
Oh, okay. Where do you teach?
At the high school.
Dawson County?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. What subject, if you don't mind me asking?
Spanish.
Oh, okay. Yep. I should probably be taking that class. I really should.
I know you'll probably have a lot of encounters where you need some Spanish.
Yeah, I do, and it would help a lot. I don't know. I say I don't have the time to take the class, but truth be told, I just don't make the time, you know. Maybe. But Jamey,
well,
that
it's a commitment. So
yeah, it is.
Add anything to your schedule besides, you know, working full time. It's a commitment. So it is.
That's for sure. If I could, just for the report, Jamey, let me get your phone number one more time. I had it written down here, but I can't find it.
Okay. It's 770-519-0055.
Okay, and your birth date, please?
It's June
24th, 1983. 6/24/83, and your address... Clint told me, I'm sure it's the same as his. What was his again? What is it?
It's 9304
mm-hmm.
Highway 136 West.
That's right. Okay.
And it's Dawsonville.
All right. Okay. Well, Jamey, I think that pretty much covers it. I really, really appreciate you calling me back, and I'm sorry to have bothered you with all this.
No, it's fine.
But hopefully this is going to be in the rearview mirror pretty soon, and we can all put it behind us. And I'm sorry you had to witness what you had to witness of it. You know, it's not right. It's not right for the guest and the crowd that was there. You know.
Yeah, I just I'm not. I know you've heard a lot of opinions. I just feel like. I mean, I don't know, and I've seen some of the new stuff, and I really don't feel like it went like that at all, and I just hate it, because if that was the truth, that'd be one thing, but
right.
I don't think anyone there thought that she was being hurt, you know, like that she was being handled incorrectly. I thought, you know, that's probably like the least violent way to get someone out that's hitting you and pitching a fit, so I just hate that for,
right.
you know, for police officers in general, because y'all get a lot of bad raps about stuff, but... Yeah, hopefully it'll be in the past pretty soon.
Yeah, I do. I do too, Jamey. I really do.
All right. Well, thank you. And if you have any more questions, then just feel free to call me, and I'll call you back.
I will, Jamey. I appreciate it.
All right. Thanks.
See you. Bye.
Bye.
End recording.